Shalom, my friends. Allow me to share with you a few thoughts relating, of course, to the parasha, the Shabbat that is coming, Bezrat Hashem, Parashat Vayehi. Vayehi Yaakov Be'eretz Mitzrayim. The Torah is telling us, and Yaakov lived in the land of Mitzrayim, Sheva Esre Shana, 17 years. Why is it that it says that he lived? Why did the Torah find it necessary to tell me that he lived 17 years in Mitzrayim? Well, Baal HaTurim says that Vayehi means that he lived. If you count the numerical value of Vayehi, Vav is 6, and Yud is 10, that is 16, and Het is 8, so 16 and 8, that's 24, and Yud, that concludes the word Vayehi, that's another 10, and together is 34. So to tell us that the truth is that Yaakov Avinu lived 17 years in Mitzrayim, but thank God he stayed with Yosef in Mitzrayim. Since the day that he was in Mitzrayim, he stayed with him 34 years. Those were the years, the only years that we can say that he lived. Otherwise, all the years before, you cannot call them life, because he suffered so much. What was the suffering of Yaakov? Everybody knows. Esav, number one, his brother, persecuted him. And Yaakov was very scared that he, as we read in the Parashat Vayishlach, that he was very scared from him. Why? Because he would have to confront him, according to some opinions, that he was afraid that maybe he will have to kill his own brother. Because Yaakov also was endowed with great power. But he was also afraid that maybe Esav would kill him. Who knows? Of course, the question that we should ask is, how is it possible that Yaakov was afraid when he had a personal promise that God made to him? And he said to him, "Ushmarticha b'chol asher telech." Don't worry, Yaakov, because I will protect you wherever you go. But the Talmud in Masechet Sanhedrin, it says there, Shema Yigrom Achet. Because Yaakov Avinu was a very great man, very righteous man, and a real righteous man should be afraid always that no matter how greatly righteous he is, nevertheless he should always suspect himself that maybe he committed some kind of sin. And if he committed any sin, perhaps it's possible that although there is a protection from God, maybe one sin would overthrow the possibility of that promise. So Yaakov Avinu, being such a tzaddik, such a great and righteous man, he was afraid that maybe he committed any sin that could have changed the mind of God from protecting him, right? So that's the reason why he was afraid from Esav. So first, he had years of terror, of being scared from the possibility of having to see Esav, his brother, who has sworn to kill Yaakov. And we all know that Rivka, his mother, sent him away for that purpose, so that to avoid the possibility of confrontation between Yaakov and Esav. Of course, his father Yitzchak also told him to go, but his intention was that he should find a wife. And that's how we know that Yaakov Avinu, when he left, so after many years, so he went to Lavan, and he saw Rachel, he fell in love with Rachel, and then Leah was given to him before Rachel, and then he had to stay 7 more years, and maybe 14 more years by the house of Lavan, so that he can take Rachel also as a wife. So first, he had the problem of Esav, which made his life practically like hell. And he had the problem of Lavan. Lavan was not such a good man. And since Yaakov was innocent, a man of tremendous cleanness and purity, and he had to live many years in the house of Lavan, who was not such a pure man. He was a crooked man, and he had to live by him for so many years. Now imagine when you have to live to be in company of a person who is not so good. If you stay with him for a long time, it is practically unavoidable, inevitable, to take a few bad things from him. But we were assured of that Yaakov did not take anything from the ways of his brother Esav, for his brother, anything from Lavan. As we know, when the day of this confrontation between Esav and Yaakov, Yaakov did send his emissaries to Esav, and he informed him that he lived in Lavan. Why was it necessary to tell Esav that he lived by Lavan? So our sages explain, based on what it says in the Torah, that Yaakov said, "I'm Lavan Garti, and I lived with Lavan," and the word Garti became like the word Tariag, which means 613 commandments, mitzvot. And our sages said that although I have lived with Lavan for so many years, still I was able to practically perform the 613 mitzvot of the Torah. What does it tell us? In other words, it means to tell us that Yaakov is telling Esav that I have lived a life as much as possible. I have done all the commandments, which means he kept his purity, his integrity remained safe, despite the influence of Lavan being with him. So those were years that were not easy for Yaakov Avinu. To live in a life, for a tzaddik, to live near a rasha is not considered life. So therefore, Lavan, which is Lamed in the word Alai, remember Rivka said to Yaakov, when she's the mother of Yaakov, when she sent away Yaakov, she said to him, Alai ki lelatecha beni, the curse that should be coming upon you, which is symbolized by the word Alai, which means upon me, your curses. So our sages explain Alai is the acronym of Alai. Ain is Esav, the problem of Lamed, which is Lavan, and the third problem is Yud, Alai, and Yud represents the problem of Yosef. So the terrible time that Yaakov had since the day he thought that his beloved son Yosef was dead. So he mourned for him 21 years. He mourned for him. So if you take the troubles, the days of terrible misery since the time of Esav, plus the time of Lavan, add upon them the life of that he had to have during the time of that he thought that Yosef is dead, this was not considered life. And therefore, the only life that remained for him was the time that he stayed with Yosef. Those were 34 years that he stayed with Yosef, exactly the numerical value of Vayehi. This is the explanation of Ba'al HaTurim, that Vayehi, numerical value of Vayehi is 34, and it represents 34 years of rest and serenity of the in the life of Yaakov since he lived in Egypt with Yosef. At the same time, we have to ask a question. Why is it that this parasha, which is going to tell us the story of the departure of Yaakov, it's talking about the death of Yaakov Avinu. He lived 147 years, and now is going to pass away. So we are learning about his death, first about his sickness, as the Torah says, Vayomer el Yosef, inne avicha hole. And the emissary came to Yosef to tell him that his father is sick. When the Torah says he is sick, it means he's about to die. By the way, our sages said that Ad Yaakov lahava chulsha. Until Yaakov, nobody had sickness really. Who knows what it means exactly? Probably there was a sickness, but the sickness that leads to death did not exist then. So people, when the time of their death came, they just passed away and that's it. So they never had the time to think about repentance or bettering their life. They would die suddenly, which is not good in the opinion of the Jewish people. But Yaakov prayed that there should be sickness before people die. This way they would have the time before they die, they would have the time to repent for all the sins that they have committed during their life. And when such a possibility is given to us to repent before we die, is a tremendous gift, because when a person repents, especially before he dies, he cannot do them anymore, right? So his repentance is quite sincere, and therefore he would gain access to Olam Haba, to the world to come. So that's the reason why Yaakov Avinu prayed that there should be sickness before death. And that's why the Torah is telling me here the story that the emissary came to Yosef to tell him, "Inne avicha hole," your father is sick. Such a thing we don't see in about anyone preceding the story of Yaakov Avinu. I mean, he didn't say that Abraham was sick or Yitzchak Avinu was sick. It doesn't say hole. But when it came to the first time we see the word chole, which means sick, is by Yaakov Avinu. This caused our sages to understand, Ad Yaakov lahava chulsha. Until Yaakov there was no sickness. Death came suddenly, and that's not good. It's important that people should be sick before, even for a short while, but at least the time to say sorry to Hashem. It's very, very important, by the way. So that's the reason why it says about Yaakov that he is sick, and he called upon Yosef. And he said to Yosef, he's the king of Egypt. So he called upon Yosef, and when Yosef came, even his own father did his best to get up a little by Shtahu Yisrael al Rosh Amita. And he practically bowed. How is it possible that a father would bow to his son? We don't see such a thing happening, and it should not happen. But to teach me that a king requires respect and honors, even though he was his son who is the king, nevertheless, the father should show honor and respect towards royalty, especially that our sages say, Melech shemachal al kevodo en kevodo mahul. A king, even though he forgives his honor, which means he's not angry that they don't give him honor, even this is the kind of king that we are talking about. And probably, of course, when the king is the son of somebody, and if that guy who is the father of the king does not show respect, probably the son will not show any resentment towards that. Nevertheless, our sages teach us that the father also should show respect, because we show respect to royalty. So that's why Yaakov, even though he was sick, he got up to show respect, and he bowed before Yosef. What was that he asked from Yosef? He said he begged him, he made him swear that Yaakov, that he should live, that when he dies, he should bury him in the land of Canaan, the land of his father. And the words here are Veshachavti im avotai. He says to Yosef, I want to sleep. See, there is no death by people like Yaakov. So he says, death for him is to sleep. So he says, permit me not to be buried in Egypt, but promise me that you will not bury me in the land of Egypt. I want you to take me to the cemetery in the land of Canaan so that I can sleep with my forefathers. By the way, our sages teach us from this, in the Midrash it says, that from this we know that a good man should try to be buried in a place where not near somebody who is evil, because then there is a big problem. In heaven, it says so in the books, the Rishonim say that when somebody is a righteous man and he is unfortunately, incidentally buried near someone who was not such a good man, so unfortunately in heaven, they do not teach him the secrets of the Torah. Well, anyway, that's another issue, and I wouldn't like to talk too much. Therefore, I have to conclude the talk by saying, Vayehi Yaakov, at the time when we read about the departure, the death of Yaakov, the title of this parasha is Vayehi, and Yaakov lived. This insinuates that Am Israel Chai. We know that Yaakov, his name is also Israel. Why? Because everything that happened to Yaakov, he suffered very much in his life. Well, is there any nation in the world that suffered more than the Jewish people? Everything that happened to Yaakov, our sages say, that happened also to the Jewish people. Yaakov suffered, the Jewish people suffered. At the same time, we know that we, no matter how much we suffer, nevertheless, we are still alive. Why? The Jewish people cannot die. It's the chosen nation by God. Of course, we die. In every generation, people die and die. No question about it. But grosso modo, when we see it in a general way, the Jewish people does not die. Because despite all the persecutions and that we have suffered and all the suffering that was the lot of the Jewish people, but the Jewish people today is strong and well, and that's why we say to everyone, we sing, in fact it's a song, Am Israel Chai. The Jewish people is alive and it is a living entity that can never perish. Shabbat Shalom.